mind the noise in the background. I think my neighbor's mowing his lawn. March. Anyway, got some pretty bad bead leaks in the Grim Ripper. So I'm going to try to stop those leaks with some bead sealer. I figured I'd show you, well, there's many ways of removing small tires and breaking the beads. I'm not going to remove the tire, but I need to break the bead so I can put this bead sealer on the inside of the rim here. You're going to need a valve stem remover. I didn't want to spend money to buy a tool, so I grabbed just a valve cap that has a valve stem remover on it, and I've screwed a chopstick into it. Works for me. So you're going to have to remove the valve stem. This one doesn't have any air in it. That's why I'm attempting to fix it. So really, what you need is some sort of scissor jack with a base somewhat like this. Trailer hinge, something solid, nice bumper, so you can apply some downforce. And your tire, nice piece of wood underneath, make things solid. I'll start by just putting pressure up against it. Line the edge to the edge of the rim. So you're right there. You might have to move the tire a little. Good stuff. Now, because I'm a lazy bastard, I'm just gonna spin her up with this. I need to stand on the tires, maybe. I don't know. I don't know how bad the beads are. There goes one. I just flip it over and do the same on the other. I love it. Now, it really doesn't take much pressure either. If you don't have a drill, don't worry about it. It just takes a little longer, but just turn it. It's not like you're lifting a car, so you can just keep doing it. It won't outpower you. And you can always use a socket at the end of it with a ratchet. Go, you know. But yeah, let me break the beads on these, and then I'll break out the bead sealer. And gonna sand the insides of the rims and then clean up the rubber on the bead side nice and smooth, and then I'll apply the bead sealer. Back shortly. Okay, I'm gonna use some bead sealer here. Oh, let me flip my lens around so I can see if I'm in the camera or not. I can't see it anyway. Alright, I'm going to use some bead sealer. Got to cover up the brand name because the Google Nazis will penalize me for showing a brand name, whereas professional YouTubers out there seem to be able to get away with everything. Anyway, read the precautions. I got this at UAP Napa. I would imagine that any reputable parts store of some sort would carry it, but definitely read the label. There's static warnings and open air ventilation, or you know, blah blah blah, you know what I mean. Good ventilation, don't get it on your skin, all that crap, wear gloves and blah blah blah. So just be careful with this stuff. I don't know what the big problem is. It'll probably stick to you and stay stuck to you or something. Who knows? Just don't use the stuff lightheartedly, keep in mind. So I sanded out the insides. I'm just gonna put my knees down a little bit so that I can access the bead. Pretty sloppy stuff. And it says just to put a light coat. Oops. It's gonna be a little sloppier than anticipated. My head's probably right in your way too. Should have thought about that. But it comes with its own applicator. Just don't wear anything that you want to keep, because if it gets on your clothes are pretty much screwed. So I'm going to try to do an even coat all the way around, but my main concern is if I get it all the way around, I'm good to go, regardless. This stuff's kind of expensive. But when I thought about how much inner tubes are, even if I only use this stuff once, it pays for the inner tube. I got lots of tires around here that could probably use this gunk. I think they use this for coating aluminum rims as well when they start to pit. Oh yeah, is that enough? I don't know. Got some slopped up on my tire there. But I guess the first one's always gonna be sloppy. That should be good. Good enough for the girls I date. And flip her over. And we'll do the same here. Now the instructions didn't say anything about waiting time or drying or anything. All it said was to try to make it even. So no clumps and lumps. And when you're on the valve stem side, I guess it'd be a good idea not to paint over it. I don't know if I got enough air in my compressor without having to turn it on, but let's see if I got enough to get the beads up. Say don't get it on your skin. And see how much I got tomorrow. So I put 30 pounds in. Figured I'd wait till my compressor shut off. And we'll see how she goes. They would have been flat by the morning. But something tells me I'll be good. Let me just clean this gunk up before it dries. Not that it really matters. That's the inside of the wheel anyway. So there we go. Why buy inner tubes? This stuff probably, it doesn't say anything about shelf life, but if you keep it sealed and in a equalized temperature, you should be able to use this for quite some time. I couldn't get anything smaller. But even still, if I use this on a few tires, stop the leaks through the beads, I've saved myself in inner tubes. I'll give you an update on the Grim Ripper soon. Been doing a little bit here and there, but winter kept coming and going, and spring and winter and spring, and who knows what the hell's going on. Right now we're kind of in spring. So yeah, I'll do an update on the Grim Ripper sometime after I post this. Well, it's the next day. Amazing how time flies in YouTube land. Let's see how much pressure we got. Just a little under 30. That could have been just enough from just relieving the air pressure here. And the other one's exactly the same. Cool. No more bead leak on the Grim Ripper. Ha ha. Oh, I found this on the side of the highway. I've had it for 15 years at least. Really nice. Works great. I guess some tire guy left it behind. Thank you, tire guy. I made good use of it over the years. It's a very high quality one too. Made in Germany. Ciao for now.